Hi, this is Nacedo 375 coming to you from New West Wales, bordering the Pacific Ocean. I bought a lathe last year, December 2010. It's a model 69E South Bend with 16-inch swing and 8-foot bed. I've got to do a spindle bearing adjustment. I thought it'd be kind of fun to make a video and share it with you and show you what it takes to check for spindle bearing play and how to make the adjustments if necessary. Going to be using some information I got from Bulletin H4, Keep Your Lathe and Trim, originally published by South Bend Lathe Works. So to get started, you put up an indicator, you set up an indicator on the spindle nose here, or the collar of the spindle. I guess the nose would actually be out towards the threads. Don't put it here on the chuck, don't put it up on the chuck or on the test bar, which we're going to use to pry up on the spindle and check the play. So let me re-aim this at the indicator, and then I'll pry up on the bar and you watch the indicator. Okay, here we go. This is a little grunt and groan thing. You're supposed to have at least a foot of pipe or bar stock hanging out from the end of the spindle, and South Bend says to put it in the taper. I didn't do that. I chucked it up in a three jaw, and the excess is extending into the spindle bore. So let me pry up on this now and watch the thing. This is a bit of a grunt and groan thing here. Okay, there's 4/1000ths. I got 4/1000ths play. Let's try it again. Looks like this isn't quite maybe zeroed. It might be almost 5. Now there's 4/1000ths. Okay. Now that I've determined I've got play, let me tear this whole setup down. I'll get the bearing cap off, taking these bolts loose here and here, and two more in the back behind here. And I'll get reset up. I'll show you the spindle, show you the bearing cap, and what it takes to adjust everything. Okay, here's the bulletin I was talking about. It's Bulletin H4, and the name is Keep Your Lathe and Trim. Originally published by South Bend Lathe Works. Google this. Google Keep Your Lathe and Trim. A site should pop up. You should be able to download it in PDF format. And I printed mine out and front backed it. It's pretty cool. Not in color, but it's clear. So if I go over here to page 15, it starts off with spindle bearings and tells you all about it. Now if you have the spindle bearing where the cap has a dovetail key lock on it, I'm not going to cover that one. The procedure's in the book, and there's certain things you have to do to take the cap off. I have just a plain bearing cap with no dovetail key lock. That's the one I'm going to cover. This is a neat book, and there's your procedure for that special key lock. So let me get set up. I haven't pulled off the bearing cap yet. I'm going to pull off the bearing cap since I got the shims I need made up. And when I get that done, I'll set the camera up and we'll go from there. Okay, I got the bearing cap off. There's the spindle. Boy, it's getting fuzz from the air already. To me, it looks pretty darn good. Notice how these two holes, notice how this hole is drilled off center. The hole should be like here and here, and it's like offset. And these aren't perfect, but they're a lot better on this side. But this obviously had to be done freehand, unless something came loose in the machine. If they had it set up in a fixture, something came loose. But it looks to me like they drilled them all freehand. And if you look at the bearing cap, which I'll show you in a minute, the top where the hole starts into the bearing cap up here is also a little offset, and then it just kind of carried on through at an angle. So yeah, I was surprised, because everybody hears about the precision of South Bend Lathes, and I was amazed, frankly. But at least I got a decent looking spindle there, and I've got the shims off already. These are ones I didn't make here. The ones These are three, they're 4,000s each. And then I made this one. And this one is 15,000s. So 15 and 12 is what, 27? And it's the same on both sides. So I'm going to take three of these out, which is 12, and put in a 10 along with this one. And that'll make 25. So it'll decrease it by 2,000s on the side. So we'll see what happens then. Okay, here's the bearing cap. Again, here's the shims I took out, the 15 I made, and the three that I decided to use. Some of these are really not so good, are they? But these three are going to be replaced, like I said earlier, with a 10. So, there it is. And these two will go on this side. Now this one, notice the bolt pattern? Not exactly drilled straight, is it? Look at this one. I'm amazed. Something must have slipped at the factory in 1925 or 1926. I'm amazed. But the bearing looks very good. And I don't think it's hitting right here and here. The bearings are all supposed to be hand-scraped originally. But I don't know. It looks to me like it's not rubbing there. But everywhere else it looks pretty good. And the bearing is, to me, it looks really good. That, of course, is the oil hole, because this assembly is turned over and the oil cap is on top. So I'm going to change it out, get rid of those three, and then I'm going to put a 15 and a 10 on each side. So that should lower the bearing cap by 2,000s, and we'll see what happens. Okay, I got everything back together. This time I have a Mutatoyo dial indicator on there to show you the new clearance. I had to change the shims. It turned out the small shims I took out, three of them, they're not 4,000s, but they're about 3,000s, or 3 and maybe 3/10. So three of them equal just a hair over 10,000s. Well, I took them out, put the 10,000 shim in, and I had still 4,000s clearance. Or, you know, play in the spindle, clearance in the bearings. So, I took the 15,000s out, put in four, a little over 3,000 shims, and now I've got a total of maybe 23,000s, and I've got 1,000s play, and here it is with the Mutatoyo first. I don't know if you can see that. I'll put the digital one on there. That one shows up better. I just wanted to verify with a conventional dial indicator that I did have at least a 1,000th play. And here it is with the Syntec, or the, I like to call it the Harbor Freight digital dial indicator. I guess there's no dial to it though. Here we go. 1,000th. Takes a while to get the readings. And if you're spinning something and indicating with that indicator, you know, it doesn't respond as quickly. But it is easy to read from a distance, and it's kind of cool. It's a new toy. Okay, we've adjusted the large spindle bearing on the chuck end of the spindle. The small spindle bearings adjusted the same way. Put a pry bar in the spindle bore. This one fits pretty well. I'll pry up, you watch the indicator. 1,000th and a half. Okay, let's try again. Okay, 1,000th and a half play. That's right in the middle of the tolerance. At least 1,000th, no more than 2. So we'll let it go. This is the spindle take-up nut. I'll have to set the camera up and get you a better view of this. This is how you adjust the end play on the spindle going this way, back and forth. Okay, here's a better view of that adjustment collar. This collar here is split. Loosen the screw and it turns on threads on the spindle. This way increases play. This way decreases it. When you're done, I'm going to loosen it up a little bit and adjust it later. When you're done, just snug it down with the screw. It's not going to spin on you. You have to put a dial indicator on the spindle and then measure your play fore and aft going this way. I just push pull on the chuck. Remember, you want at least a thousandth and not more than two thousandths, and don't let it get less than a thousandth of an inch. Okay, hope you've enjoyed the video. Good luck working on your lathes. See y'all later.